हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर कल्पेश पटेल, इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम द महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। आवर सब्जेक्ट इज पाई इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स ऑफ द बी थर्ड ईयर फिफ्थ सेम एंड द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 3140915। आवर सेकंड चैप्टर नेम इज एसी टू डीसी कन्वर्टर स्विचिंग वोल्टेज रेगुलेटर्स। सो दिस इज द फ्लो ऑफ कंटेंट्स फ्रॉम विच अप टू द बूस्ट कन्वर्टर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कंडक्ट द बक बूस्ट कन्वर्टर। सो बक बूस्ट कन्वर्टर इज स्टेप अप एंड स्टेप डाउन बोथ द इनपुट वोल्टेज। बक बूस्ट रेगुलेटर प्रोवाइड आउटपुट वोल्टेज दैट मे बी लेस देन और ग्रेटर देन द इनपुट वोल्टेज, हेंस द नेम इज बक बूस्ट। So the output voltage is polarity is opposite that of the input voltage. That's why it is also known as the inverting regulators. So at the output side we get the reverse polarity of the input voltage. Buck boost regulator. The circuit arrangement of a buck boost regulator is shown in figure. The circuit operation is divided in two modes. During mode 1, transistor is on and the diode is DM is in reverse bias condition. So input current rise linearly during the mode 1 and flow through the switch and the inductors. And during mode 2, transistor is in switched off and current linearly flow through the inductor and the DM is in forward bias conditions. So the inductor through the capacitor and capacitor through the diode and also form the load. So in boost converter here we get the negative polarity. So the output voltage is the negative of the input voltage. So this is the equivalent circuit of the mode 1 and this is the equivalent circuit of the mode 2. So during mode 1 transistor is on, so here we get the positive signs. So this diode is in reverse bias conditions, so this no current will be flow from diode. So the during mode 1 current is flow through the switch and switch through the inductors, and during mode 2 Q1 is off conditions, so no input current will be flow IS. So now the inductor will be act as the energy source. So in these conditions this terminal become plus, so the current is flow through the inductor to the capacitor, and in these conditions the DM is in forward bias conditions, so it will conduct the current also through the load. So this current IL is consist of two current, capacitor current IC and the load current IA during the mode 2 operations. So this is the waveform of the mode 2 operation buck boost converters. So at t equal to 0, transistor Q1 is fired up to the time interval KT. So 0 to KT is known as the mode 1 time and T1 time or a T on times. So in these conditions voltage VD, which is the voltage across the diode, is given by when transistor is on, so DM is in off conditions. So voltage across the diode is magnitude Vs, which is equal to the input voltage. When switch S Q1 is turned off, so the voltage across the diode become negative because at this side we get the positive polarity. So voltage across the diode become the minus Vs during time KT to T. Now the inductor current IL during the transistor mode 1, the inductor current lies linearly from I1 to the peak value I2, and at the peak value I2 reach at the end of this mode of operations at the time KT. So in mode 2 switch is turned off, so the inductor current decreasing linearly from I2, so it magnitude is from I2 to the this difference in peak current and the current I2 and the I1 is known as the delta I. which is the ripple current in the inductors. Now the current I1, which is the current through the diode, is during the switch on, the diode is in reverse bias condition, so no current will be flow. But during the mode 2, it becomes the forward bias condition, so the diode current become, diode is in forward bias condition. Now the current will flow through the diode, and which is the equal to the inductor current. And so the voltage across current through the diode is the same as the current through the inductor, and which is given by this value, which is same as the current in the inductor during mode 2. So this is the diode current, and the capacitor current IC. This is the capacitor current IC. During mode 1, our transistor is on, so capacitor current flow in negative directions. So this value is given by the in negative, and its magnitude is IA or load current. During the mode 2, the capacitor now increasing linearly its voltage. So after end of the interval mode 1, so the current through the capacitor become positive and reach at the peak value I2 minus IA, and after that it is decreasing linearly because this capacitor is discharged through the load. So in this mode it become zero. Further repeating the cycle, it become negative and it increase from mode 2. So the voltage across the capacitor is the VC. It has the negative magnitude because it reverse bias, reverse current will be flow IC. So this value VC is decreased during the turn on time because no energy transfer from source to the load. So in this situation, energy will be transformed by the capacitor, and the capacitor voltage is linearly decreased from VC to this value minimum. And when switch S is turned off, now the capacitor is charged through the inductors. So this voltage is increased linearly. So this difference between the peak value and this value of the capacitor is known as the ripple current in the capacitor. Also, this is the ripple current of the load. So at the load side, the magnitude of IO, which is the load current, so it is continuously flow. And switch S is off condition, the current is supplied by the source as well as the inductor. But during the off condition, on condition of the switch, the current is supplied by the capacitor. So at the output side, we get the continuous voltage current. Now we will derive the all the equations of the input current, output currents, ripple current in the inductor voltage, ripple voltage in the capacitor, ripple voltage in the capacitor voltage, and also the load current and dead duty cycles, step by steps. Assuming that inductor current rise linearly from magnitude I1 to the its peak value I2 during the time t1 or on time. So in these conditions, voltage across the capacitor, which is the fully voltage appear across the Vs. So this Vs equal to the L I2 minus I1 divided by t1. So L I2 minus I1 equal to the delta I by t1. So by this equation, t1 equal to delta I L divided by Vs, and the inductor current falls linearly from this peak value I2 to the I1 during time t2. So in these conditions, the inductor current become negative. So here delta I is indicated as a negative, and voltage across the inductor, which is the same as the output voltage VA. So this VA equal to the minus L delta I by T2. So by this equations, T2 equal to the minus delta I L divided by VA. So delta is the ripple current, peak to peak ripple current in the inductor. It is defined as the I2 minus I1. So delta I equal to the, from this equation, delta I equal to T1 into Vs divided by L. Vs T1 divided by L. And also from this equation, delta I equal to the minus T2 VA divided by L. Minus T2 VA divided by L. Substituting the value of T1 equal to KT and T2 equal to the 1 minus KT. So VA, average voltage at the output side, VA equal to the minus VSK divided by 1 minus K. So in this equation, if we substitute the value of K equal to the 0.5, so this 0.5, 1 minus 0.5 equal to 0.5 and K equal to the 0.5. So this will be cancelled out. So remain only the Vs. So when the K equal to 0.5, the output voltage VA equal to the minus Vs, which is same as the input voltage, but this sign is negative. So it is also known as the inverting converter. Now we increase the value of K from 0.5 to 0.6. So upper side is 0.6. This K equal to the 0.6. And 1 minus 0.6 equal to 0.4. So the 0.6 divided by 0.4 equal to 1.5. So the output voltage VA is the 1.5 times the input voltage VS. So in these conditions, this converter act as the boost converter. If we decrease the value of K from 0.5 to 0.4 volt, so this is the K Vs 0.4 divided by 0.6, which gives the value 0.66. So the VA equal to the minus VS into 0.66, which decreases the output voltage by factor 0.66. So in this situation, this converter acts as the buck converter. So at K equal to 0.5, the output voltage is same as the input voltage. But K greater than 0.5, it acts as a boost converter. And K less than 0.5, it acts as the buck converters. So by substituting the value of T1 equal to KT and T2 equal to 1 minus KT into the in these equations, so it is VA 1 minus K, 1 minus K Vs minus Vs K equal to minus Vs divided by VA minus Vs. If you put the value of T1 and T2 in these equations, so it becomes this. By substituting the value of T2 equal to the 1 minus KT and 1 minus K from equation this into the equation this. So T1 equal to VA upon VA minus VS into the F. Assuming the lossless circuit, that means the input voltage is equal to the output voltage. So whatever the power is supplied to the converter, we get at the output side is 100%. So this circuit is known as the lossless circuit. So input is given to the converter is the input voltage and input current, which is equal to the Vs, Is, and the output power is given by the output voltage and output current equal to the Va, Ia. But voltage at output side is the negative, so it is the minus Va, Ia. and VA equal to the VS K divided by 1 minus K and IA as it is. The average input current IS is related to the output current IA is given by IS equal to the IA K divided by 1 minus K. Now the switching period T can be found T equal to the 1 by F, but total time T is the summation of T1 plus T2. So the T1 equal to the delta I L by VS. T1 equal to delta I by VS and T2 equal to the minus delta I L by VA. And T2 equal to the minus delta I L by VA. Here is the minus. So delta I L in bracket VA minus VS divided by VS VA. So this equation gives the peak to peak ripple current delta I. So from this equation delta I equal to the VS VA divided by into T, but T is equal to the 1 over F, so it is the 1 over F and L as it is and VA minus VS. Further solving this equation, delta I equal to VS K divided by FL. When Q1 is on, the filter capacitor supply the load current for T equal to T1, and the average discharging current through the capacitor IC equal to the load current IA, and peak to peak ripple voltage in the capacitor delta VC is given by these equations. Voltage across the capacitor delta VC equal to the 1 over C 0 to T1 IC dt, 1 over C 0 to T1 IC equal to the load current IA dt. So by solving this equation we get the delta VC equal to the IA T1 divided by C. By substituting the value of T1 equal to the VA divided by VA minus VS from this equation, VA divided by VA minus VS into F. So delta VC equal to the IAC T1 equal to the VA divided by VA minus VS into F. So by solving this equation we get the delta VC equal to the IA K divided by FC, where IA is the load current, K is duty cycle, F is switching frequency and C is the capacitance. So delta VC equal to the IA K divided by FC. Now the condition for the continuous inductor current and the capacitor voltage. So what is the minimum value of inductance and capacitance required for the continuous conductions? So ripple current in inductor delta I is given by the thrice IL. So delta I equal to the delta I equal to VSK by FL equal to the thrice IL. So K VS divided by FL equal to thrice IL. IL is the load current, which is IL is the inductor current, which is same as the output current IA. So 2IA equal to 2IL. Now IA equal to the output current, which is equal to the output voltage divided by R. Output voltage is VA divided by R, but VA equal to VSK upon 1 minus K. VSK divided by 1 minus K. So this equation gives the critical value of the inductance LC. So by if is L consider as LC critical value, so it become LC equal to the this KVS and this KVS will be cancelled out. So remaining terms 1 minus KR divided by 2 into F. So this equation gives the critical value of inductance LC. Now the critical value of capacitor VC, which is derived by the ripple voltage delta VC, and ripple voltage in capacitor delta VC equal to thrice VA. So delta VC equal to IAK by FC equal to thrice VA. So IAK by FC equal to thrice VA. and VA equal to the output voltage, which is equal to the output current and the output resistance IAR. So this gives the critical value of capacitance CC equal to the this IA, and this IA will cancel out. So remaining term is CC equal to K divided by F into 2R. So buck boost regulator provide output voltage polarity reverse without the transformer. So output voltage VA equal to the minus VSK by one minus K. So this minus indicate the inverse of the input voltage. It has high efficiency. Under faulty condition of the transistor, the di by rt of the fault current is limited by the inductor L, and it will be the Vs by L. So the when this compared to the buck converter and boost converter, buck boost converter limit the fault current. However, the input current is discontinuous and the peak current flow through the transistor Q1, high peak current. This is the disadvantage of the buck boost converters. Now the application of the chopper. Chopper are used for the DC motor controls, battery supplied vehicles. That means we have to change the voltage across the motor to change the speed of the vehicle. So this in this situation chopper are used. Solar and wind energy conversions. As we all know, solar and wind energy provide not the continuous voltage because the intensity of sun also change and the velocity of wind also change. So it will change the voltage. So we have, but we require the constant voltage. So in this situations, the buck boost converter will be used to maintain the constant voltage. Aeroplane and spaceships where the onboard regulated DC power supply are required. Chopper circuit I use as a power supply in the computer, commercial electronics like a mobile charger or power bank and other electronics instruments. Now one example of the buck boost converter is given. Find the current and voltage in buck boost regulators. So the buck boost regulator has the input voltage Vs equal to 12 volt and duty cycle K, which is the 0.25 volt. So duty cycle K less than the 0.5 volt, that means this circuit act as the buck regulator. So the output voltage VA, which is less than the input voltage VS, and the switching frequency is 25 kHz, inductance 150 microhenry, capacitance 220 microfarad, load current 1.25 ampere. Determine average output voltage VA. So VA equal to the minus VS into K divided by 1 minus K. Here K is 0.25, 1 minus 0.25, so it gives the minus 4 volt, which is less than the input voltage 12. So in this situation, buck converter act as the buck boost converter act as a buck converter below the 0.5 duty cycles. Second one B, peak to peak output voltage ripple delta VC. So delta VC equal to the delta VC equal to the this IAK by FC. IA, which is the 1.25 ampere, K 0.25 by FC. F is 25 kilohertz, C is 220 microfarad, which give the ripple in the output voltage, which is 56.8 milliwatt. So it is the very less magnitude. So this is the advantage. C, peak to peak ripple current delta I, which is equal to the VSK divided by FL. VS equal to the 12, K 0.25, F 25 kHz, and L equal to 150 microhenry, which gives the ripple current inductor is delta I equal to the 0.8 ampere. Now the peak current in the transistor IP. Current is transistor IP is summation of the two currents. One is the delta I by 2 divided by IS by K. Now the IS equal to the इनपुट करंट विच इज़ गिवन बाय द आईए के डिवाइड बाय 1 माइनस के, आईए 125 के 0.25 1 माइनस के विच गिव द 0.4146 आई एस के इक्वल टू द 0.4146 प्लस डेल्टा आई बाई 2. सो डेल्टा इक्वल टू द पॉइंट डेल्टा आई इक्वल टू द 0.8 डिवाइड बाई 2 विच गिव द पीक करंट इन ट्रांजिस्टर 2.067 एम्पियर. हियर आउटपुट करंट इज द 1.5 एम्पियर बट इनपुट पीक करंट इज 2.067 एम्पियर विच इज हाई वैल्यू विच इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ बक कन्वर्टर विद द पीक करंट फ्लो थ्रू द ट्रांजिस्टर वेरी हाई पीक करंट. सो दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ बक बूस्ट कन्वर्टर. नाउ द लास्ट वन इज द क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ एल एंड सी. सो द क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ एल सी इक्वल टू 1 माइनस के आर बाय ट्वाइस एफ बट आर इक्वल टू द आउटपुट वोल्टेज बाय आउटपुट करंट. सो इट इज आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज माइनस वी ए बाय आई ए माइनस वी ए बस माइनस वी इक्वल टू द माइनस फोर दिस माइनस माइनस बिकम प्लस सो 4 by 1.95 विच गिव द लोड रेजिस्टेंस आर इक्वल टू 3.2 ohms. सो इफ यू पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर 3.2 ohms विच गिव द क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ इंडक्टेंस एल सी इक्वल टू द 450 microhenry एंड क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस सी सी के बाई 2 fR के 0.25 टू एफ 25 kW आर 3.2 सो विच गिव द 1.56 microfarad. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड द बक बूस्ट कन्वर्टर. सो इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल study the various control treasury techniques for control the output voltage. Thank you.